Let's talk about something different here in education matters and taxes as well. Egerton University has agreed to pay nearly 875 million shillings owed to the Kenya Revenue Authority after the taxman took top officials to court for failing to meet the institution's tax obligations. In an agreement between Vice Chancellor Professor Rose Mwonya and Deputy Vice Chancellor in charge of administration Isaac Ibwage on one side and KRA commissioners on the other, the university leadership also agreed to surrender a title deed to its land measuring more than 1,500 acres. Marianne Nyambura now joins us live from Nakuru. Marianne, how did this tax evasion happen over a long period of time without anyone noticing?
Well, that is something that is subject to investigations. That is what actually most of the staff here in the Egerton University actually insisting on. I remember this is something, or rather, for them, they're actually saying that if this situation is not dealt with immediately, then it will put plunge this university institution into a financial crunch. I remember this is, we are talking about 856 million shillings, 741,693 million shillings. That is debt which has accrued over time. Now we've been duly informed that the institution has not been submitting or rather remitting their statutory deductions, be it NHIF and SSF, and even for what the staff here actually saying is that the pay slips are actually reflecting that amount has been deducted from their pay slips. But it's something that is subject we've tried to speak to the Vice Chancellor Rose Mwonya about this whole issue, but our calls have gone unanswered as well as our texts. But what we can say is that there was a debt agreement that was made between the Egerton University as well as the Kenya Revenue Authority. As you mentioned, they were supposed to pay 40 million Kenya shillings immediately. The debt agreement was signed. That was on 26th of September 2019. Then thereafter, they're supposed to pay 816 million shillings, 741,693 shillings in a span of 12 months, starting from last month, which is October. And we've also been duly informed that it is on course at the moment. We've also been informed that they are supposed to surrender their title deed, which is over 1,500 acres, to the KRA as part of security. Then thereafter, if they don't submit or remit all their taxes, then that will subject them, or rather ensure or make KRA to give the full amount, then KRA will be forced to come here and take the whole debt, the whole amount, which is 816 million shillings, 741,693 Kenya shillings. So at the moment, what we can say, Trevor, is that the debt agreement which was signed between the Kenya two tax commissioners from the Kenya Revenue Authority Commission, as well as overseen by the Vice Chancellor of the Egerton University, Rose Mwonya, as well as the deputy in charge, reveals that they are actually the accounts which were actually frozen were taken back, or rather the institution was given the mandate to take it back as long as they follow that agreement. But of course, this is something that the staff members here at the Egerton University are actually saying that needs to be dealt with immediately, and that investigations need to begin into this whole amount, 816 million shillings, 741,643 shillings. Is not just a little amount of money that is debt that has accrued over time. But what they are also actually saying is that their pension schemes have not, or rather for the pension scheme, the NHIF and other statutory deductions have not been submitted. This is something that they say that needs to be looked into. Of course, this whole issue stemmed up from the fact that the leaders here are claiming that there's mismanagement within the institution that has plunged the institution into this debt crisis. But it is a story that we will definitely keep an eye on and give our viewers real-time updates.
Absolutely right. Thanks, Marianne. That's Marianne Nyambura speaking to us live from Egerton University, where they've now agreed to pay up to 857 million shillings to owed to the taxman. They're also giving away 1,500 acres title deed of their land to compensate as well.